Well, good morning, people of the interweb. Today on Auto Addicts, I'm waiting for a mate to come and pick me up because I don't own a Volkswagen and we're going to White Noise. I'll see you there.
Auto Addicts.
So, as you can see, we've arrived, and here is the steed that took me. My mate Mark 1 Scirocco. But moving into the show field, we find that, obviously, as you'd expect at a VW meet, lots and lots of air-cooled stuff. So, Beetles, some more Beetles, a Beetle with a surfboard. I'm really not good at these. I'm going to say that's a Type 4. Don't know, some sort of an estate car. I like it anyway. Rather ratty looking Beetle. I love the swamp coolers. You see it on a lot of 50s American stuff as well. Sort of an old fashioned version of aircon. Quite snazzy light covers, headlight covers on these. This I actually really like. It reminds me very much of the early 90s Street Machine movement. The lights in the front and rear, sort of Frenched in, you see Dalmatians. That sort of peach colour, very, very 60s, very, very 90s Street Machine style. Great to see something from that era still surviving. Most of them would have been updated by now. Caravan matches the car, so to speak. Cuffs map. Collar matches the car. Anyway, yeah, we're moving swiftly on. As with a lot of the Beetles, obviously, all done different ways. Notch back there. I wonder if that's the one I saw at Buffalo, very retro, did years ago. This is stunning. There's just no other words for it. It is stunning. It is exquisite. Lovely Carmen gear. Beautiful paint job. Lovely colour. Credit to whoever restored this. Really, really done nicely. I like this a lot. Yeah, lovely colour. I forget what those wheels are called. Are they Fuchs or something like that? Porsche wheels, anyway. Another sort of notchbacky type thing. What we got here? Don't know. Another whatever mistake things are. Some more Beetles. Another Beetle with the headlight covers. I like those headlight covers. And some more Beetles. And a cow. The rear of a, I think that's a Jetta. Obviously a VW van. All done up like a cow. Teat 4, that's very, very droll, and a mini cow, baby cow, baby cow, baby cow. Anyway, yes, moving on, more Beetles. Quite an early one there, horse wheels again. Obviously we go onto the vans. I like that split window there, nice and sort of ratty looking. Some bay windows. Split window with opening front windows. They don't all do that. But yeah, obviously all done up slightly different ways. Great thing with this movement, it's all very individual. This Audi, I love. It's obviously on air. But it's just as is. Period rear. Parcel shelf speakers, obviously. Golf there. But yeah, I do like that Audi a lot. A little scan round. Yeah, got to be a rare car. Moving on to something slightly different. Obviously, we have some BMXs, but we also have this. The Vector. I desperately wanted one of these when I was a kid. And I couldn't have one. They also did them in black, which is the one I wanted. But as you can see, it's got radio, got little sirens and sound generators, and it's basically just a BMX with a computer on it. But I really, really wanted one. The black one was just very... anyway. Street Hawk. Motorized cooler, some more BMXs. Surprising amount of money's worth sat there now. Golf Rally. Tell with the different headlights and the wide arches, left-hand drive only, I think they were. A couple of Mark II GTIs. Moving along the line, Mark I Golf there. And again, all done up differently. The engine bays, they seem to have gone to town too on a lot of these. I did quite like that orange one, but I am partial to an orange vehicle. Quite like that blue one as well. Don't know what that is, 16 valve, is it? Trumpets on and fuel injection. Little Mark I Polo there, rather nice. I seem to think that it did have something special under the bonnet. I can't remember. Caddy there, another Mark I Golf. Mark I Polo, sorry. Very nice. This Caddy, I did quite like that. They've got wood on the front bumper and the little chrome strip down the side was also wood. May see this on the channel in the future, you may not, but it's friend Sophie and Luke's there, a Mark I Golf with the VR6 engine in it and rear louvers or rear blinds, swallowtail rear end. It's not a swallowtail obviously, but it's been played about with, but very nice. Lovely little Jetta and a bread van. Mark II Scirocco. Bread vans seem to have got quite expensive of late. They're no longer the sub-£1,000 car they once were. I'm rather taken by that Jetta.
Yeah, I do.
Got here a little Mark I cab. Lovely interior in this. Again, something done with the engine. I'm no expert on these things. It's just, I think it was a VR6, I could be wrong. That red one has got a 2.8. It's a 2.8 V6 in it. Out of an Audi TT, probably. So, moving along to the Corrados. Again, I do quite like a Corrado, but I didn't make them early enough. Anything I buy moving forward really needs to be tax exempt, and these aren't. But I do quite like them. And we have a good selection here of VR60s, G60s, 1.8s. And modified and stock. Just nice little selection. So, moving across to this row, we've got a Caddy van there. Which I'm guessing is on air. A little Lupo. Mark IV Golf. four golf action, and is that a golf or is that an Audi? That's an Audi. 911 Porsche, proper 80s Filofax and braces. Newer Porsche. And this one isn't a Porsche 911, this is a Porsche 912. Or 912, which I think had a 1.6, if memory serves, but I'm certainly no expert on Porsches or Volkswagens for that matter. This is all new to me, this stuff. But yeah, a 912 rather than a 911. Obviously a tribute to the Fast and Furious car. And fairly accurate, apart from the fact it's right-hand drive and not left-hand drive. A Dragon Green Mark III. We used to have a Mark III Golf when they weren't worth anything. So back to that Mark II Scirocco, which I believe is a previous Best in Show winner. Modern Scirocco and another Mark I Scirocco. And you can see, well, you could, until I went back to the Fast and Furious car. But there we go, you can see this is an earlier one than Jay, so it's got the narrow front indicators as opposed to the wraparound front indicators of the slightly later ones, but lovely polished engine bay. Nice example. Yeah, I like that. I like that a lot. Nice interior. Another little bread van there. I have got the owner of that on Instagram, I think, but I forget the name offhand. TR2, beach buggy there with a great metal flake paint, and I love that interior. Very, very period. Yeah, that's nice, that is. Big old BFGs on it, obviously. A Skoda favourite. More beach buggies. Sort of Myers Manx style. I did quite like this purple one again, the metal flake. Now this Cav, Mark II Cav, SRI. You can tell where the wheels, proper SRI wheels. I had a GLSI in that colour back in the day, which was basically the same engine, just slightly plusher interior rather than sports interior. But I bought a beige SRI for £25 and drove it home from Newmarket, probably slightly illegally, just for that rear spoiler to go on my GLSI in that colour. Which was brought back a bit of nostalgia there. Anyway, some modern Audis. Beach buggy, some newer VW Golfs, some more modern Audis, a pizza killer, Ford F-Series pickup there, Ford Ranger again on air, Ford Ranchero. Pickup, we've seen this Jetta several times at different things at Thetford's. Again, I've got him on Insta. Golfs here. This pale blue Golf, the interior on this is amazing. It is stunning. I didn't hang around for the prizes, but if this didn't win best interior, it was a travesty. That's lovely. All the dash is wrapped, lovely job on the seats, even the floor mats all done the same, boot is equally as good, lovely. What's that, it's a VR6, again nicely detailed VR6 there, nice engine bay in general, that's a really really nice job on that. Wheels probably not quite to my taste, but that's the great thing with these, it's all individual. And there is his Insta, or her Insta. Lovely interior, absolutely amazing. And as you can see, the boot is just as good. Brilliant. Yeah. Pretty standard looking Mark II GTI. which is nice to see a standard one. Some less standard ones. Hopefully I don't get a content match on this music, so I shall just waffle bollocks over the top of it to try and stop such things as content matches. And as a little dog. Lovely. Anyway. So there we go. That was a little bit of this year's White Noise. So as always, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you soon.